Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to a brand new Let's Play of Offworld Trading Company, a game by Starduck Entertainment and Mohawk Games, created by the Civilization 4 dev, whose name may or may not escape me this exact literal second, so I will find out. But anyway, we're going to be playing the campaign on this game, because in the latest DLC, Patrons and Patriots, it got updated and changed and was allowed to be just much better, for my understanding. There it is. So Soren Johnson. So yeah. So we're gonna go straight in. I've done all the learn to play and I'm shit at this game, so I'm sorry. But this game was given to me by Stardock Entertainment, so thank you for that, guys. So let's get on with it. Let's go on the campaign. So we're gonna start a new one. Now there are two new people, Manuel, I believe, and Mikael. I don't know. I think they're the new ones because they. I'm guessing. I don't know. So I've not played this game. I've seen loads about it, but I've never had the luck of playing. So I play expansive, or at least I have been when I've been playing. That probably explains why I don't have any of the fun ones. Now I'm checking. So we can pick Macy Song or one of these two, Manuel Valencia or Mikhail Nekrasov. So these guys start with unlocks all HQs, free germ of geothermal plants, two water pumps, and so he starts with this. This guy, Manuel, starts with investment banker, so it's quite nice. That's pretty useful there. One free core sample per HQ level. Interesting. It's very interesting, and Maisie is extra claim. I think I'm going to play as Maisie for this, and we should hopefully see Manuel and Mikhail actually in the campaign. The settings are, I'm just going to leave them as they are. Like I said, I haven't played this campaign before. So we're going to play on the, I believe the normal difficulty is Manager. So we're going to play this for the 10 weeks, which is the ability now, which is what has been added, the ability to change campaign settings. So every part will have a every part will have a week, so let's get into it. So as we play, it's 10 weeks long. Number of corporations is 10. We start with 400 grand. Income is 150 grand. We start with num round, growth rounds are free. Don't know what that means, so we'll have to look into that. We cannot hire contracts until week 2. Alternative colony and wholesale mode over every other week. Highest victory? None yet. So welcome to your first campaign game. In the campaign, you will be competing over territories with the CEOs. You will battle for business in territories where new colonies are being founded. There are a few different rules when playing in the campaign, and this being your first time trying it out, we're going to highlight some of the most important ones. That's pretty nice of them. I'm very thankful. Business opportunities. You have a few options each round where to expand your business. The choice matters in each location, has unique rules as well as bonus for winning. As you can see, there is also a lot of more going on this screen. Take a look at your other options, and make your choice. After you've selected the location to launch your next business in, click the hire staff button. Will do. So I'm guessing that's these. So we can click them over here. So Utopia Plantia, which is we get steel shipments, so 20 shipment for the HQ, or upgrade HQ. If you buy the colony colony module at the end of the 7 souls, you'll be rewarded with the following perk. Some shipment. Olympia Undy. Mission reward is Goon Squad, which basically you get a free Goon Squad per game. And it basically protects your people, which is pretty fucking cool, actually. I like that. And Galactic Chaos, which is Power Surge. If you buy this the most colony modules and the 7 souls, you will get a free Power Surge per game. So these are all different. What's this? Bribe, claim, mule, filthy pirates. So is that what could be expected again? So what's location info? Colony growth medium, plains, north, low, color resources, black market infantry. Oh, so it's saying what the black market sells and who the opponents are and the rewards. So we could get some Chinese support, American support, which is one extra claim. That, yeah, so we're probably going to have to use the Utopia Plantia. Because there's no... See, these are the guys I'm guessing who can subsidize you. And if I'm honest, I'm not going to lie, I kind of like the extra claims. So these are the stuff we can do, I'm guessing. So we get an extra claim, and we can play as expansive. We can't do those. So we're just going to have to go straight into Utopia Planeta. Instructions staffing in the campaign, you must spend time and money to improve the effectiveness of the production buildings. They start at half the speed of buildings in regular games, so these upgrades are critical. Certain instructions even need to be unlocked, which is pretty cool. Below your name, you will see the structures and CEO bonuses you start with. The numbers next to the structures represent the number of employees supporting those structures. I already have a lot of cool stuff. Hiring and upgrading. You can always improve your production speed by hiring engineers. Contracts can be signed for a single week while employees can be hired for the entire campaign. Advanced buildings require engineers as well, but instead of enhancing the output speed, they support more advanced structures to be constructed. Finally, there are specialists and upgrades which provide some very cool options should you consider taking advantage of. You should consider. So decisions to be made. That's 150k. So, Well, I mean, steel mill is extremely necessary for us, so I'm going to contract that straight away. Glass is important, so is geothermal. Geothermal is probably the most important. So is food. Food can be worth a lot as well, so I'm actually going to get food and I'm going to get the extra steel. And I think I'm going to go for solar condensed engineers. What's that? That's water, CO2, and carbon. I'm not really too fast about this. It's not something I really care too much about. So I think I'm going to get the free water pump. Oh, I can't. It's 200 grand. So you know what? We're just not going to spend any more money. So we're going to launch the business. Let's do it. Showtime! You've decided which region to launch your business in and have hired the right people to make your business a success. Things are looking good. You now have a chance to scope out the competition and make sure you're ready. You can always go back and tweak your choice if you want to. Things look good. So these guys have spent all the money apart from Manuel. So we have currently a... I don't think it shows who does what yet. So, let's see. So, they're steel mills. I have 4 steel mills. So, I'm gonna definitely focus on heavily on steel, as steel is very important. Can't focus too much on glass. It doesn't really... So, you're robotic. Rennie 6 is definitely robotic. Doesn't show what she is. So, I'm guessing they can be other ones. Like, no, fuck it. Let's just get into this. And we'll see what we can do. And we've got the achievement campaign started because, well, we started a campaign. there's low resource presence as well. That's not good. So let's see what we can do. Now, I must stress that I'm very bad at this game. I've only played for like probably 2 hours, and that was at 5 this morning preparing. So now's your time to shine. You can see an unscanned map and the burgeoning colony of Utopia Plantia before you. You'll need to scan the map, find your company, and get some production up and running before you get too far ahead of yourself. There's a few things you need to learn if you plan on making a go of it. The first thing is, you only have 1 week of time to build your business and make your money. That's just 7 days to... Wow. Taking stocks in the colony. If you've done a lot of business on Mars, you may be familiar with buying out the competition. During the first 6 weeks of the campaign, your early investment option is buying modules for the colony. These modules can grow the colony's population capacity as well as working opportunities. So why should I do that? Ultimately, the business that invests the most colony module reaps the largest harvest. The biggest investor in Utopia Plant will receive the steel shipment. Not only that, but based on the ownership percentage and colony size, each business will receive weekly dividends and profits from the colony. I can do that. Shipyard. Increased demand for aluminum and electronics. Teleportation is forbidden by local ordinance. Planet unavailable. Patent unavailable. About this class, shipyards are owned and operated by private companies. Mars has no ocean, and yet, as yet, it has no integrated highway system. Either ships produced at main Martian shipyards are mostly airships, with a lesser demand for orbiters and for spaceships capable of off-world travel. Teleportation technology would be anathema. I don't actually know what that word is, to airship sales, thus most companies forbid teleportation research and development near the shipyards. So, we need to find some stuff.
Low levels of aluminum found, high levels of carbon found.
Well, we're not a carbon-based industry, we're a heavy, very...
High levels of silicon
we're
found.
An iron company, so we really need...
A geothermal vent. That, this will be useful.
That really got her rocks off to that, love. She just fucking was like, oh, yeah.
A scavenger HQ has been found. High levels of water found. Low levels
there
of
we go.
Found. High levels of iron found.
So fuck it, we're gonna just drop straight down here. So we've got four claims. So I think the first thing I'm going to do is we're going to get some steel, iron metal mines going. Get some steel going. Now we have one more tile left and we need aluminium to grow. So I'm actually going to immediately invest in some aluminium. Because of the fact that we need it. So we're going to grow as slowly as we can. I'm not the best at this, like I said, so we're gonna it's going to be very hard to really be winning. I don't intend to win the first one.
Has been upgraded.
So this scavenger bitch has already grown. Which I say is fucking rude.
A robotics HQ has been upgraded.
We need more claims to do anything, so at the moment we just have to wait. I don't know how if I've done this efficiently or not, but I've got some aluminium. It's gonna ship when it can. I'm making as much steel as I can.
The black market is online.
We'll bribe a claim, we'll get ourselves a new claim. Aluminium is definitely something that seems to be a good idea to get a bonus of. I've already got 3 grand in debt, but I'm not going to worry about that too much. I'm actually going to put the game up to fast because I like to play on a decent speed. Now I have won a game in this because that's how you unlock the campaign. So I do know how to win, but my strategy is probably not going to be the best strategy for winning. Right, we've upgraded. Let's get some water going. Think, how much is that costing? Zero. So we'll get 2 war pumps. I think we'll get some more metal. And I think another steel mine will be good. Wait, what is this one? It wants...
HQ has been upgraded.
They want aluminium and electronics, so getting more steel isn't really an option. Getting more aluminium, though, that is.
The black market is open for business.
So we're going to sell our steel when we can. We're going to try and get some stuff on the place.
A robotics HQ has been upgraded.
Well, fuck them. They're good at this game. I'm not. So we'll do the best we can. I think getting some more claims would be a good idea, but at the moment we need to just need make money with the stuff we've got. Which is, at the moment we just need to continually grow. At the moment aluminium is something we have a lot of. So, I'm going to sell 100 of it, so I can get closer to being able to... I can actually buy a colonial warehouse, which... Seems okay.
A scavenger HQ has been upgraded.
HQ has been upgraded.
So I've bought a colonial warehouse. Don't know why I did that, because it was I need the money, but oh well. I shouldn't have done salt that much, but I did. My debt is rapidly increasing because of the fact that I'm not making any fuel or anything. So until I have some money, I really can't do anything. So actually, yeah, selling steel isn't going to make much money. Not steel, iron. The problem is we need glass. HQ has been upgraded. Yeah, I'm going to... Yeah, they're already level 4 in that. I'm definitely going to fail in comparison to keep up with them. Which is very unfortunate, but that's just... I need to get better at the game, and that's until then... I'd sell the steel, but that wouldn't mean... That wouldn't, like, help. When we get some steel, we're going to get some electrosis... Electrosis... Fucking this reactor that helps us get fuel and power so we don't fucking... F everything up. Let's get two of them. Let's pump out the money. We've got more than enough water pumps. What's electronics?
A new claim is available for auction.
Yeah, I'm way in debt. I want you to pay more than 10 grand for... Oh. Yeah, there we go. I'm not paying anymore. I'm not paying for that. Yeah, I'll let them fight about it. Now, I was going to build something. Build some electronics, because of the fact that I'm getting some aluminium and getting steel. I don't seem to be making steel fast enough, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to increase my steel production. This should help me win.
HQ has been upgraded.
Yeah, we're actually getting... We're not getting too low food. We are buying food, though. We need more claims, though, to get the food. I can't tell who's winning here.
An expansive HQ has been upgraded.
Yeah, I need to upgrade my expansive HQ up. So hopefully we're going to do as well as we can, but at the moment I don't seem to be. What's this? Oh, my electronic fashions. So... Apparently I need carbon and sulfur as well. Didn't realize that. Well, that's my own. Oh, right. I wasn't looking at the right place. I need 17 grand to upgrade. Sulfur is fucking miles away. At the same time, I'm gonna go for it. Unfortunately, we need food as well. So we'll get as much food as we can now. I'm definitely losing this. Bar laboratory warehouse. Buy a habitational module. They're up to 5. We just need to shit out stuff that makes us win. Steel does not seem to be as valuable as fuel. So I'm gonna get some fuel going as well. He's up to 6, that son of a bitch. I'm up to 5. Okay, selling that wasn't really a good idea, but oh well. No, someone says I've got a surplus of... They're up to 7. Okay, these guys are definitely gonna fuck me up. We're on fast, we're on day 4, so I mean, I don't have to worry, I don't have to get worried too much. I mean, I am in a shit ton of debt. So I should probably be worried, but I'm not. $20,000, which is more important? Get some workplaces. This guy's up to 8, how the fuck is they doing that? I suppose I'm just not in my... I'm not really good at being competitive because of the fact that I've lack of playing. Take the fucking aluminium off me. I do not need it. At the moment, I'm just trying to sell shit that has value to it. And I'm trying to catch up to this bitch's 9. And the power being as expensive it is what's fucking me up right now. So I think I'm just gonna speed up to 10 and just accept my inevitable loss. So the first month isn't going exactly as we planned. As a company, we're not doing the best. Which is, it could be worse, we could be losing.
New land is available for auction.
Looks like Rini's winning now. Some warehouses.
Congratulations.
I mean, I'm doing the best I can. Which, let's be completely honest, probably isn't enough. Yeah, they're up to 14 and I'm not even up to 8 yet. I'm up to 9. I'm up. Okay, I was up to 8, but someone increases the price of fucking steel, which is dumb. The fact that's what I'm good at making. It's just not helping me. Oh my god, they're up to 17. Okay, so Rini has definitely won this, or Rennie. Rennie is a prick. But I need to get, I think I need to spend some time building up my knowledge of this game so I can do as I can. So, I'm going to have to accept third place on this one. I am over 600 grand in debt, which is not good. This can cause vast problems, I'm going to say, for my campaign, having this amount of money in debt. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to mitigate that by upgrading and building my power base. So we need silicon. I'm basically going to spend the last time on fast trying to build some power. Anywhere that's 1.1 will do. We need to try and make some money of the fact that I'm using way too much of the colony's power. So I've got 3 more claims left, which I intend to make a usage of. I'm basically just going to play on the power game on this one and just take all the money into account. Try and rob the myself back into debt, because losing to 900 grand is not acceptable. The only problem is it's night time, so I'm not exactly going to pick up at night, but on the day they should make me, yep, there we go, debt is crawling down significantly fast, like a significant speed. So we just need to pay to get our debts off now. And actually, you can still buying stocks gets you points. I didn't know that. Well, I'm still, yep, they bought stocks and now I'm not even in last. And how much are they in debt? Wow, how's my debt so bad? I really fucked up the debt games. Yeah, power's not even worth shit anymore because of me. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I have fucked this, like, completely. Seems to be a shortage in everything. I'll accept that. Yep, I lost that one. Yeah, let's return. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go to the... we're going to exit the mission now. Because we lost. So it looks like Rini got the steel shipment. So let's look at new expansions. So metal mine or an elemental quarry. Would you prefer a free metal mine or an elemental quarry when founding your HQ? Metal 9. So yeah, I tanked my shares. I'm over 700 grand in debt. And no one else is in debt. So, ladies and gentlemen, I will see you guys in the next part. But unfortunately, I fucked that up a lot. See you guys in the next part. See you guys then.